This is the Hughes family. I am Nathan. This is Courtney. And Hudson is not with us currently, but we'll explain that a little bit later. So we are just hopping on here. We want to share with you our experience that we're getting ready to have because we got a new house. So we are, this is the first night that we're actually starting this, what's the word?
Renovation,
I guess, Rebuild? Per se, getting ready to move
not
in.
Not really. We're just like painting.
Yes.
And
so
fixing things up.
We got all of our supplies. Tonight we're gonna start spackling, and
there's a lot of holes in the walls.
Yeah, there's lots of holes in the walls. So we're gonna start spackling, and then we also have to paint tomorrow, and we're also going to be tearing up some carpet, get down to some hardwood. So it will be a lot of fun, and we'll keep you posted, and Courtney will give you a tour of the house.
So we are going to start at the front door. So when you walk in the front door, here is the living room. It's so much bigger in person. Like, pictures and videos don't do it justice. So we walk down here, and here is the hallway. So this is gonna be one of our biggest projects. It's gonna take lots of coats of paint, so that'll be fun. So this will be our bathroom, obviously. We're gonna paint the entire house white, just because it's easier that way. So anyway, then come back out, and then to the left is a bedroom. We actually bought this bed. It was in the house, so that was nice. But this is one of the bedrooms. We're actually going to rip the carpet out of this room here. So that's what Nathan is about to do. They left this here. I don't know if that's actually staying or not. Anyway, so then you continue going down the hall. On the right side will be mine and Nathan's bedroom, which looks tiny, but we've measured it and it's like the same exact size as our bedroom now, and our bedroom now is really big. The only thing that is might be a problem is the closet. Very small, but we'll make it. Anyway, so all of these rooms will be painted white. And you come back out here. This is Hudson's bedroom, which we actually did tear the carpet out of. We have not cleaned it up yet though. So that will need to be done. It was like a very, very bright red shag carpet. So it was pretty nasty. What?
We can give them pictures. We have pictures of the carpet.
Oh, that's true. Okay, we'll insert those. So this is the hall, and then there's like a little linen closet here, which is really nice. There's also a closet in this bedroom, but I'm not walking in there because I have socks on. So anyway, here is living room again. So we're gonna walk through. And here's the kitchen. We're not the biggest fans of this floor because as you can see, it used to be white, but that's okay. We'll fix that someday way later in the future. So it's actually pretty nice. I'm not a big fan of the countertops, but we'll probably put like sticky stuff, like, I don't know if you've seen it. It's kind of like, what would you call that? Like
peel and stick
countertops. It's basically just like tape, so it makes it pretty, but you don't have to replace it, and it comes off pretty easy. So that's probably what we'll do in here. And then if you go down here, there's like the water heater and that tiny little bitty attic space that I don't even know if my 6-month-old could fit in there. So then, here is the laundry room, which has so many cabinets, and I'm so thankful for that. So nice. And then there's a quarter bath in here, which is not extremely cute, but that's okay. We're not even going to worry about this right now because we're just not, it's not a priority. Probably won't even get used that often, so. Then off of the kitchen right here is another room. It was, look at that stain. Looks like somebody died there or something. But anyway, so this was technically like a family room, but Nathan and I have talked about it and decided we're going to make it into our guest bedroom. I know we have an extra bedroom. That is the bedroom that I showed you guys. I know we have an extra bedroom in here, but in case we ever have girls or anything like that, then we'll have still have a guest room. So that makes it nice for us. And this is, I know it doesn't have a closet, but it'll be fine for guests because they won't be staying that long. Anyway, so that is our new home. So we are here on a Friday night. We are getting some things done, just spackling, and we've already come and taken all the nails out of the walls, which I don't know.
This is the last one.
I don't know if you can even see. Look, there's like so many, all those like dark spots, those are all holes. So we have to redo, spackle all the holes in the walls. This house is extremely old and I don't think it like was ever redone, redecorated, repainted. I think it just stayed the same way for years and years. This house was built in the what, 60s?
Yes.
60s. So anyway, so we're here on a Friday night. We dropped Hudson off at my parents' just to spend a couple hours so we could do things and not have to worry about Hudson because these carpets aren't clean yet or anything, and we don't really want to set him on them.
So tomorrow we will have more to show you because we're trying to get everything ready for tomorrow when we're going to start painting. And so my parents are coming. I don't know. Her parents have talked about
it. They talked about it, but they have something going on tomorrow night. Yeah, so it just depends if
they
have time.
They might not come. They might come. So we're trying to get ready for tomorrow so that we can really get into gear and get stuff done.
Yeah. So eventually our goal is that we will have all the rooms painted white, because if you know me and you know my style, everything is just black and white and gray. It's just my style with a hint of like yellow accessories and stuff thrown everywhere. But so I'm very plain and my furniture is gray, so I don't want gray walls. So white really was just the best option, right?
Yes.
And white really goes.
Paint everything the same color, it'll be easy.
Yeah, it's just easier that way. But, so yeah. So a short little story about the house. So this house actually belonged to George Wagahoff, which was my, what, fifth cousin, something like that. He's like, we're related, but like,
distantly
related. So anyway, I've actually been to this house before when I was like 7, and I barely knew the guy. All we knew about him was that he had a Wagahoff rock out in his front yard, and that's what drew my dad's attention. So we actually, I don't know what happened, I was only 7, I don't really remember, but he looked him up and got in touch with him, so we met up with him. And we actually came into the house and talked to my parents for a long time. And all I remember is that my mom told me to sit down and be quiet and not touch anything, you know, like good moms do. And so that's all I remember of this house. I don't really even know him very well. But anyway, so we found out that, okay, sorry, I'm skipping parts of the story. My dad and my grandpa have been extremely into their history recently, and they've been like visiting people and just reaching out and seeing people. So they wanted to come see George Wagahoff because they knew he wasn't doing well. He was, I don't know if he was in the nursing home or if he was just at the hospital or something. He was just sick or something. But it ended up not working out because of the spike in COVID and stuff. And his family just decided it would be best if they didn't, because he wasn't doing very well. Well, then a few weeks later, they found out that he had passed away. And so my dad was talking about he was going to go to the funeral. And so that was part of the plan. And we had just been talking about it, our family had. So then Nathan goes into work. Was it the next day?
I think we talked about it on a Friday, and I went to work on Monday, and that's when it happened.
Okay. So he went into work on Monday, and his boss was like, have you ever seen that Wagahoff house? Nathan was like, yeah. And he was like, is that any relation to your wife? Nathan was like, yeah, they were cousins of some sort. I'm not sure how distantly related they were. But anyway, his boss was like, oh, well, I bought the house. Nathan was like, really? You did? He's like, yeah, I bought the house. I guess he had bought it for somebody else, but they said that it was too big for them. And so his boss was like, have you ever considered living in that house? And Nathan was like, no, like it's never crossed my mind. But I mean, we'll talk about it and pray about it. And this was the next day, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the next day, maybe it wasn't the next day, because I think that was on a Thursday.
It was the next day. Anyways.
So we went to this Journey of Bethlehem thing. It's in Racine. It's like just like a walk through Bethlehem, and you get to let, it's like a live action thing. You get to walk through and like, what is that called? Like,
it's a immersive experience.
So anyway, we were talking about the Wagahoffs, and George's granddaughter Lori had been talking to my dad. They had gotten in contact about some stuff and blah blah blah. I don't remember the whole conversation. It just all went by so fast and it was all so crazy. And my dad, literally, we were talking about this on this hayride up to the actual place, and my dad was like, that's Lori right there. Like, we're literally talking about her and she's right there. And so we got to meet her, talked to her for a while, and Nathan was like, my boss just bought your granddad's house. And it was just such a weird coincidence. And so many things like lined out with each other, and everything just like was put into place like so perfectly. And everything, I don't know, I can't even explain it. Like, obviously God wanted us in this house. So we told Nathan's boss that we would pray about it for about a week. And if we had peace about it, that we would take it. And if we didn't, obviously don't. So anyway, we prayed about it for about a week, and everything just seemed perfect. And everything was so smooth sailing. It was so good. So we decided to take the house, and here we are. Now we are getting it ready, painting. And we should be moved in the next couple weeks. We're going to a couples retreat. Is that next week?
What?
Is the couples retreat next week?
No, the week after.
Week after, so 2 weeks. So we're moving the week after the couples retreat. So we're excited, and we're going to drag you along on our little journey.
Working hard or hardly working?
A little bit of both.
Courtney's spackling, putting a lot of trust in you. I'm just kidding.
Probably a bad idea.
So she's starting that, and I'm getting ready to clear.
How pink these walls become.
I'm getting ready to clear out the next room and start pulling up carpet.
Here he goes.
This one doesn't even have tack strip on it.
That's nice. Starting on the carpet. That may have been why it was loose and we actually found the hardwood. Also, just so everybody knows, we are not pros, so don't make fun of us.
Yeah, we are definitely not pros.
In fact, I would say we are very unqualified.
That's okay.
But we're gonna get the job
done.
Cheap. Yeah. Also, don't mind our Encanto music playing in the background. If you haven't seen the movie. Yeah. Yeah, Stinkin' Hudson watches it every day, even while he's napping. But if you haven't seen the movie, you should definitely go see it. We got this huge hole. We got a patch. I don't know if you can tell how big that is. Ginormous. I think I've done it as good as I can for right now. I'm gonna let it dry and then come back and do it again. It's pretty thick.
thick there.
We got one bedroom done, which I shouldn't have started in here. I should have started on the other end of the house because that's where we're painting tomorrow. But that's okay, this room had to be done too. And there's our huge hole that we're working with. So that's probably gonna take a couple of times of spackling it. So there we go.
I don't know yet, but I think they might have glued this padding down. They didn't do anything on the other one. So the other wood wood floors look great. These might not look as good because I think they might have been glued down. So we'll have to take the rest of the padding up and see.
That looks a little rough there. But I guess we'll see. So now I am spackling the pink bathroom. It's literally, the walls are so bright in here that it's hurting my eyes. Like, it's legitimately giving me a headache. It's horrible. But we're gonna get this done, and thankfully, the tiny little bathroom is the only one that's pink. So what happened?
Oh, I'm gonna explain it?
Uh-huh.
So the carpet in the red room, we took out, and it was fine. They just had tack strip on it. But apparently the bedroom that we just took carpet out of, they did it differently, and so they actually glued it down. So it's just gonna be so much more of a pain to tear up the padding. And then on top of that, we're going to have to probably sand down the hardwood and polish it. So it's gonna be a whole big project. But luckily that's the bedroom that we're not gonna be using for a while, so.
True. So we went ahead and paused on that so we could get the rest of the room spackled so we can get painting tomorrow. But this is as far as he got. He was like in here scrubbing as hard as he could and it just wasn't coming up. But so after we get all of that torn out, probably gonna have to pay to have somebody clean it and polish it, which isn't a big deal. It's still cheaper than putting all brand new carpet in it. So, but anyway, that's where we're at on that. So now we're just gonna spackle all the rooms until we're done. So we got our room done. It actually wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. The first room was way worse than this one, but I imagine this one will be pretty bad because this is where he had all of his trinkets and stuff. Well, maybe not, because I think he had shelves in here, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Well, so it may not be that bad, but it's all up higher. I can't even reach that stuff, so I guess we'll have to see. So we got all the rooms speckled. That one's already dry. So we got all the rooms done except the living room. It's like really rough, so it's gonna take probably a couple tries to get the holes out of that wall. But we just finished up in here and it literally looks like it's already mostly dry. So we're gonna wash up and head home because we have a long and early day ahead of us tomorrow.
It's day two. So today we are headed to the house. Oh look, we have Hudson with us. Say hi. Can you say hi?
He's not going to.
He's very sleepy. He needs to go to bed. He'll probably nap as soon as we get there.
It is 9:40, so 9:40. We are going to the house and my parents are going to meet us there. And we are going to have a long day of painting ahead of us.
Yep. So our goal is to paint at least the bathroom and two bedrooms.
Yes.
The bathroom, our bedroom, and Hudson's bedroom. So I guess we'll see how that goes.
We'll see how much we get done.
Yeah, because yesterday we did not get as much done as we had hoped. Nope. We wanted to get the spackling and the, we wanted to pull up the carpet and then clean both of the hardwood floors.
And I wanted to try to tape off a room, but that didn't work out, so. We ended up getting the spackling done, everything except for the living room, which living room is going to be more difficult because it's got textured walls. So we're going to have to finish that today and start painting. So let's see how much we get done.
Hudson, are you so tired? Can you laugh? Can you smile for me? Can you smile for mommy? Do I look different with a hat on? Oh, yeah? I love you. I love you so much. Starting our day with some Starbucks.
Brush it like a drip, 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 that'll never stop. Whoa. Brush it like a tip, 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 till you just go pop. Whoa, oh, oh. See if she can handle every family burden. Watch as she buckles and bends but never breaks. No mistake.
So Nathan is outside shoveling so his mom can get out of the car. He also shoveled for me, so such a good man. But he said he wanted to go ahead and shovel for his mom and dad so they wouldn't have to walk in the snow. He's so sweet. You want your phone? Here you go. Okay, so I went ahead. This spot was dry, so I went ahead and filled it in again. Smoothed it out as much as possible. This is still just in the hole, which is why it's not very smooth. This side turned out pretty good, but I think that side is going to need another coat again. So we're gonna let that dry all over again. Yeah. We're just waiting for Nathan's parents to get here. We are about to start taping off.
Start taping.
Nathan came in here and he was like, I have to take off the, what is it called? Light switch cover?
You have to take off the cover.
Yeah, so I was going to take off the cover and then he realized, oh wait, it's on the tile. We're not painting that. Yeah. So
I had a blonde moment.
Yeah. So we can probably just tape it off, honestly, just to make sure nothing gets on it. But anyway, so we're going to start with the bathroom, which will probably need, what, two coats, you think?
Probably, it's really good paint, so it'll probably need two coats, but it could need three.
Yeah, I mean, look at that. It's very pink.
Depends on if it shows.
Yeah, so here we go. We're starting. Our day has officially started. Are you excited?
Yes.
It's going to be a long day, but that's okay.
Bathroom that is going to become white.
Yep. So Nathan's mom did all the room work while we were in the other room. So now we're just rolling. I did most of that. It's gonna need a lot of coats. But
I can still see it seeping through.
Yeah. It's definitely looking better though. I already love it so much better. And everything looks so much bigger and brighter. It's great. So yeah. So, yep, here we go. So, it is lunchtime.
Well, it's afternoon because it's like 1 o'clock. But,
yeah. But, Nathan's parents just left. We were going to get them on video too, but we just got busy.
Got busy.
It didn't happen. Hudson's ready to go outside.
Are you ready?
He did so good. He just sat and played with his pop. Anyway, so let's show you the progress. So far, we have this room done with the first coat. Obviously, it still looks kind of yucky. We didn't get around the ceiling though, or the light, but we will do that. And then over here, most of this is done. We still have some trimming to do just on this wall, But it's looking pretty good. And again, we didn't get around the light. We'll have to go back with the step stool and get all that done. But it's looking good. Obviously, it'll have to have another coat, maybe two. I don't know. We'll have to see. But anyway. So, here we are.
Is there any ketchup?
You want ketchup?
Yeah.
I'll get you some ketchup.
And I paid myself.
You paid yourself?
I paid for myself.
Yeah, you paid for yourself. You said you paid yourself. So, it's a video for our YouTube channel.
Oh, hi.
Yeah.
So,
I need
we finished painting. One second. Here's we finished painting and then went to lunch and never made it back to the house. So, my family came into town. Say hi.
Hi. I'm already here.
There's Davis
in here. We had Christmas in January.
And Lane is over there.
February.
But anyway, so really they came into town and we had our Christmas. February 5th. But we did it. So now we brought the kids to McDonald's. Can you say hi? Say hi. He's upset because he can't have those chicken nuggets. But anyway. So I think we're calling it a night. We're gonna go back to the house and clean things up and do some more later. So, do you just talk all the time? I turned away and Hudson pulled my burger into the bowl. So, Nathan went to get me another one. Hudson. You should be ashamed of what you have done.
The heck no.
He doesn't look like he cares very much.
He's a bad boy.
Our one and final try at this big old hole.
It seems to be working better.
Yes. Time. Yep, so... as Courtney told you, we had a little bit of a side trip because family unexpectedly came, so... We just got back, and it is very late, so we're going to call it a night. We're just wrapping a few things up.
Well, we were going to call it a night, but I've decided that I want to finish this.
Oh, excuse you, sir.
And then I'm going to finish...
We're going to finish the trim and the painting around the trim in the other bedroom, so...
Yeah.
Somebody has been very sad... Because he doesn't want to be left alone. He gets very scared, so...
I think it's more so because he wants to be home.
Yes, he wants to be home and he's very tired. It's been a long day, so we're kind of stuck at the hip right now.
So, I think that's about as good as it's going to get. We're probably just going to leave it like that and then sand it before we paint. I'm thinking that's a win. So, we're having to pour some more paint... Obviously, because we already cleaned everything up. We just got to do the trim along here. Not the trim, but around the trim. Anyways. Are you going to be okay? Are you fake coughing? Are you fake coughing? Do you need some attention? Well, Nathan switched me. Nathan? He's concentrating. Because Hudson was screaming and wouldn't stop and just kept saying mama. But he's obviously content now. He is such a goober. He is definitely a mama's boy. Are you a mama's boy? Yeah, you are? Do you love mama? Yeah. What?
I'm doing way better than I thought I would.
Yeah, so we banned Nathan from doing the trim earlier today. But because he, like, spilled paint everywhere. Ow! That hurt. Don't pinch my fat. That's not funny. That actually really hurt. I'm gonna bruise. But anyway, he did a very bad job. And he's just very messy. So we told him not to do it. But since we switch, he's attempting, and he's actually doing a very good job. Proud of him. So, and it's looking very neat. Are you just, you just have so much to say. Really? So you're okay with your bedroom being white on the walls and hardwood floors? Maybe we can get you a little rug that matches your room? I don't know if that was a yes or a no. The hardwood floor will make you look like a man instead of girly carpet, right? Don't pull mama's hair. What can I say? He loves me. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. I took Nathan's place again because his hand was cramping. But I did it. I finished it. So, all the trim is done. All around the trim. So, tonight it will dry. And then, probably Monday. I'm not 100% sure on that. We will come back and do the second coat. The only thing we haven't done is around the light, because neither Nathan nor I feel comfortable doing that, because it just sounds like a big old mess. So we'll probably ask my dad to do it. So yeah, we're excited. So we're wrapping things up. We're gonna clean some things off and call it a night. Also, if you can't tell, my baby is very upset because I'm not holding him at this moment. But that's okay. It's been a rough day. Has it been a rough day? Mommy hasn't held you all day long. Excuse you. I love you. Can you say bye-bye? Oh, you faker. I love you. Hi, everybody. So it is Sunday afternoon, and we have decided.
Wait, guys.
Oh, look at the puppy.
Third wind.
Look at the puppy. Anyways, so we decided to go ahead and go back to the house today and try to get those two rooms finished. Go ahead and get the second coat on them. So we are headed to do that now. We left my son. That was weird. I don't usually say that. We left Hudson at my parents' house. So we're gonna try and go get that done, and hopefully the second coat will be it. And it
we're
won't
being
need
very optimistic,
anymore.
But we'll see if it pays off.
Yeah. So hopefully we won't need any more than just the two coats. If we do need more, we're definitely not gonna have enough paint.
Yeah.
Like, not at all. We may not even have enough now.
Yeah.
But anyways, so here we go. So we made it to the house. About to grab our supplies here and get to work. So we're gonna start by just rolling the walls again, because we're thinking that it's possible that we won't have to redo the trim again because it's so much darker than the walls. But I guess we'll just have to roll the walls and then find out. But so we're gonna get our supplies ready and then get to work, right?
Yes.
So wow, my hair is a little crazy. I'm on this thing. We did not get lucky. We are having to redo the trim, but it's not too bad. Also, look at these walls. They look so good. The second coat made them look so much better. I'm excited to see what it looks like when it's dry. Nathan?
Yeah?
Are you excited about our progress?
I'm so excited.
It's only been about an hour and we've already repainted the whole room, and now we're just doing around the trim. That's about it.
We are on a time crunch because we have to be back at church by 6 o'clock.
Yeah. So. We plan on wrapping things up around 5.
Yep.
We set a timer to make sure that we wouldn't be late. So we're going to try to finish the trim in here and then try to do the bathroom, which shouldn't be too hard because it's so small. But anyway, that's where we're at.
We're very tired.
Yeah. So here is the room. So obviously it still looks a little rough because it's not dry. But it does look so much better. Also, it looks way better in person because like there's like light and stuff, so you can't tell how good it actually is. Yeah. But we decided not to paint the closets because nobody's gonna see inside them anyway.
And if we get to them later, we can, but.
Yeah. But anyway, looks much better. We did not get to the bathroom today. And it's 5 o'clock and we need to wrap things up.
We gotta get back to church, so.
So we're going to clean some things up and get out of here. Hopefully we can finish the bathroom tomorrow night, but at least we can say this room is done. Yes. Unless we come back and it looks absolutely awful tomorrow, but it should be okay. Yes. So yeah. Okay, so it looks like we got everything cleaned up, you know, as much as paint can be cleaned up. We are ready to go back to church, right?
Yes, we are very ready.
Got my boots on.
I got my non-boots. Oh,
and
I need to roll my pants.
And paint on his jeans.
Yeah.
Dude, you're a mess. Messy. Well, anyway, so we got that cleaned up and now we can go to church. So we just got in the car to go to church and I have lots of paint in my hair. Well, golden hour. I don't know how that happened, but anyway, I guess I'll need to comb that out before we get there. So we are proud of the work that we did today. You're proud?
I'm proud.
We didn't get done what we had set as our goal, but I've noticed over the last couple days that
we
aim high, which
yes.
is not a bad thing. It's good to have goals.
It's good to keep you motivated.
We set our goals really, really high.
So, we're probably, I don't think there's any way that we can get it all done before we need to move in. So our goal is just to get, because we just finished our room. And the bathroom is going to need another coat. And then we're going to try to do Hudson's room. And once we get those three rooms done, we're going to see if we can have our landlord get the carpets cleaned. And then we will move in after that. So.
Yeah, so our plan.
Hopefully we'll move in next week.
Hopefully.
Hopefully.
But our plan is to like move in like one room at a time. And then like pack, because we only live like what, 10 minutes away?
Yeah.
So our goal is to like pack everything and bring it over and unpack it like for one room at a time. And then that way everything will be set up when we get moved and it will be much easier. But since the bedrooms are the first ones that got painted, that kind of messes things up because we're either gonna have to live in suitcases or we're gonna have to live over there without any of our other stuff. So it really, I don't know, we'll have
it's
to.
It's going to be a rough couple of weeks.
So we're going to just have to try to figure out, see what we can do. But we'll figure it out like we always do. But.
That's all I got to say.
Okay.
Except for my hair looks beautiful.
So I think that's probably it for this video this week.
Yep.
So I guess we'll see you in the next video.